this compute. And this is the code from this course. And the credit is 3 SKS. And the lecturer is me. And for the prerequisite is introduction to telecommunication system. If you refer to the curriculum 2020. And if we refer to the curriculum 2016, the course is telecommunications engineering. The class schedule, yeah, we always open at every Monday, start at 10 a.m. Yeah. And since we are in online, yeah, because there is not recommendations or there is no rule from the rector for offering the course offline. So as long as no informations about the offline class, we will use a Zoom meeting. In this case, this is the link that we can use every Monday at 10 a.m. This is the alternate way for accessing this link. Okay, and also I want to let you know that the learning outcome from this class is we expect you to be able to identify the needs of long life learner, become long life learner related to the current issue, yeah, related to the electrical engineering. And also we expect to the expect you to able to be able to formulate a complex engineering problem, yeah, complex engineering problem by applying method and devices effectively to solve this problem. And this is the general learning outcome, yeah. And specific course learning outcome, we expect you after complete this course, you can explain many type of wireless communications and also the cellular concepts and component in wireless communications. And also we expect you to be able to analyze the network performance, yeah, network performance based on the convergence principle. And this CLO, course learning outcome, then decomposed into 5, yeah, into 5 sub CLO, CLO. There are 5 components, yeah. First, we expect you to be able to explain the concept of telecommunication system, including near cable, cellular, and satellite. Also, expect you you can analyze the theory formulations, mathematical formulation related to the wireless communications. Expect you to explain the concept of network system and telecommunication network. And also explain the engineering traffic, yeah, and also can design, yeah, you can design a specific system in wireless communications, either 2G, 3G, 4G, or 5G. Actually, it's not whole system, but part system. At least you can explain which part you can design, and then what is the benefit of the system you design, something like that. And this following is the scope of materials. We will talk about the NGN overview, NGN policy and challenge, broadcasting and network security, and also we move forward to the wireless communications. We will talk about the signal propagations and path loss models, millimeter wave propagation, shadowing, combined path loss, shadowing model parameters, statistical fading model, narrowband model in phase. Yeah, this is the complex signal representations. So complex signal means that consists of real and imaginary part. Uniform AOA, angle of arrival, and then signal envelope distributions, then wideband fading, Doppler and delay spread, and capacity of wireless channel, capacity of flat and fast fading channel, linear modulation review, linear modulation and its performance, probability of symbol error, combined average error and outage, and impact of Doppler, diversity and maximal ratio combining. The reference that we can use first from ITU, International Telecommunication Union, about the Next Generation Network Global Standard Initiative. You can access from this. And also the book, the title is Wireless Communication, written by Andrea Goldsmith from Cambridge University Press. Okay. And also we talk about the evaluations. How to pass this class or this course? Actually, we divide it into three type of evaluations. First, individual assignment. It will be 14 times, not 15, yeah? 14, yeah, 14, with the proportion being 60%. Yeah, total individual assignment for 14 times. The total, if you fulfill all the assignment, you worth it, yeah? You worth for having 60%. At least if you conducted all of the individual assignment, you will pass, yeah, this course, yeah? No need to conduct the midterm or final exams, yeah? But yeah, if you fulfill all the assignment. And then also you have to another chance to increase your score, of course, by conducting midterm examination only first time. Only one time. Yeah, the proportion is being 20%, as well as for the final examinations. This is the proportion is also 20%. Okay, allow me to describe the evaluations. First, about the individual assignment. Student, the assignment, what kind of assignment here? Every assignment, student should create a video or short video explaining the topic of each week. Yeah, each week you should explain and record. And then student upload the video into YouTube to the given channel. The username here, kelasnirkabel@gmail.com, the username. And the password is kelasnirkabel2021. Submit the YouTube link before the deadline. Please consider that the deadline is 1 week. 1 week. So for example, today's class, we will talk about the NGN overview. And then you have to make an assignment, individual assignment, 1 week ahead. You should finish uploading the video to this channel. Scoring rules. Yeah, there are many score level that you can get from this individual assignment. 0 if student do not upload the video until the deadline. 60 student upload the video. Yeah, just upload it. Student explain material clearly with the number of like equal to or less than 20. Student explain material with the number of like greater than 20. If you got the 20 likes from your video, you will get 85 score. 95 if you get more than 100 score. And being perfect if you get like more than 100 and get comments. Yeah. So at almost the end of this class, actually at actually not July, yeah. This is later I will revise. Students should submit number of like of each assignment from assignment 1 until assignment 14 until 24 December 2021 for each assignment. Yeah, this is not to July, yeah. But 24 December, yeah, 24 December. Later I will revise. And how about the mid examinations? Mid examination can be easy, can be essay or multiple choice. Yeah, not decided yet. Score is based on the result of assessment. Yeah. Your assessment, result of your assessment. And the final exam is individual project using MATLAB. Yeah, individual project using MATLAB. The assessment consists of two types. First component, students submit the MATLAB program, output program, and analyze of the output analytically. Yeah, so you have to write what is the meaning of your output program. The score is 60%. And the oral assessment related to the project that student has created. Yeah, it means that what is the oral assessment means that every student should explain or, yeah, the assessment can be maybe oral or by face-to-face. For example, I am asking 3 question or 2 question, depend on the situations. The score is 40%. So in this case, I give you a tips. Make sure that you understood what you conducted in this individual project. If you just copy and copy somebody's project or your friend and you don't know the meaning, it will be risky, yeah. Risky. It is okay to maybe to conduct the assignment cooperatively. I mean, you maybe you get together and solve the problem together. But the report is should be conducted in individual way. And then you have to know, you have to understand what you written, what you create, or what you program. And then in this, this is the course content. This is another layout. What I have written here. This is the Excel. Maybe you can download and open. Actually, the content is similar to this. Maybe I will revise this point and this point. Wait a moment. This 24 December, and this is 4 times, yeah, 14 times. Okay, so yeah, you have, I hope you read this carefully, and then maybe you have questions. Anybody have a questions? Maybe is there any question?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So,
is it possible for you to change the parameter for the assignment evaluation?
Parameter. Okay.
Yes. Yeah, so, for the number of likes, is it possible for you to change it?
Oh, okay. What's your opinion?
I think if from 85 to 95, the difference is a bit too large. Maybe for 95, it's 50 likes, maybe.
This one, 50?
Yes.
Oh, okay, no problem. Yeah, I accept it.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
Sorry, sir.
Yes, please.
It happened that I haven't enrolled to the class yet, sir. When trying to enroll myself, it requires some enrollment key, sir.
Okay, okay. I will let you know the enrollment key.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. So, okay, wait a moment. So everybody, I write here the enrollment key. Maybe where should I put here? Maybe here, yeah. Enrollment key for a mass, yeah. WCN 2021. Okay. Is there any other questions?
Sir, I want to ask about the final project.
Yes.
Is it possible for me to use other software other than MATLAB? For example, if I use Octave.
Octave. Is it Linux based? Is it right?
Oh no, it can be used in Windows too, but it's open source. So
open source. Yeah. It is very much possible. Yes.
Okay, yes. Thank you very much, sir.
Yes. Can use Octave or another option is wait a moment. I forget. There is another one, the open source, like a MATLAB, like a Octave. I forget, sorry. Maybe later I will tell you. Yeah, actually this MATLAB I know really well. If you want to access the MATLAB and you have to pay, or if you have to if you want to a free license, there is a you need to install, maybe you have a chance for 60 days 30 days, yeah, 30 days for accessing the MATLAB freely. But in this case, I will provide you MATLAB by sharing a computer, maybe what we conducted in the last time when we create software in Signal system, maybe, yeah, using sharing computer, something like that. So don't worry for accessing the MATLAB here. And also it is permissible, yeah? It is permissible for you to use another software, yes. Okay, is there any other questions?
Sir, can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
About the video, how is the duration of the video?
Yeah, there is no limitation, so up to you. Yes. It is actually is depend on your creation, your innovations.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yes. Okay, is there any other questions? Yeah. For example, once you finish, maybe we almost done for this class after maybe 16 meeting. Instead of you submitting the URL of the video, you have to count how many like you get from your video. Actually, you have to submit at maybe it's in the topic 16, maybe after week 16, yeah, later. Yeah, this is just information for you. Every week, you only need to submit the YouTube link from here, yeah, in the assignment one. Currently, it's still hidden. Maybe after this course, I will open. Okay, is there any other question before we continue to the our materials? No, No. If no, yeah. Let's get start to this course, yeah, actually. So in the topic one, there is a information gathering game, yeah. I want to check, actually this is no effect to the your scoring. I want to check the initial knowledge about this course. Yeah, you can open and by click this link and you will directly to this Excel. Yeah, there are two questions here that everybody should answer. First question is mention type of telecommunication service you know, and then mention provider that serving the service in column A. Is there maybe some of you don't understand the questions, or maybe you want to ask something about the questions? If no, yeah, please conduct. Don't be shy. You can answer any, yeah, what do you know about the telecommunication service and the provider that serving the services. Okay. Actually, I don't know who are tipping here. Because there is anonym. Okay. Okay, good. Nice. Maybe I should zoom. Oh no, it cannot be zoom in. Okay, good. 200? Oh, no, it's too large. Okay, good. Okay, very nice. Yes. Okay, some of you writing TV broadcast fax. Yes, good. Okay. How about the fax? Yeah. What kind of provider? For the facsimile, you mean facsimile, right? Facsimile services. What kind of telecommunication services served by T-Mobile? Yes. Okay, thank you very much for your participations. And actually, we will check together, yes. For example, from, yeah, somebody, actually, I don't know, who's written this telecommunication services. VSAT, yeah, VSAT. VSAT IP V-satellite, yeah, SCPC and DSCPC. And this is a telecom provided by Telkomsat. Telkomsat, and then vessel tracking system. This is from Telkomsat as well. Yes, mobile service, yeah, mobile telecommunication or cellular service, yeah. Telecommunication cellular service, yes. Indosat, XL, maybe some of you as a Telkomsel, yeah. Three, yeah. This is kind of cellular service for telecommunications by voice or by another services. This is satellite, yeah, Telkomsat. Ya, Singtel, okay. Mangoski. Maybe some of you can explain Mangoski. Actually, I don't know. Can you explain maybe who is written this Mangoski? Hello. Anybody? Hello.
Hello, sir. So Mangoski is actually a internet access solution broadband. It is satellite based from PT Telkomsat. Oh. And it is actually a solution for internet access in daerah 3T.
Oh, in rural area, in daerah,
yes,
3T.
Rural area.
I see. Okay, it is interesting. Mangoski. Is that correct, Mangoski?
Yes. Oh. Actually, you can check it out in the concept website from concept.co.id. You can check it in.
Telkomsel or Telkom?
Telkomsat.
Oh, Telkomsat.
Co.id.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
You can see the product there, and they explain the features of the Mango SP.
Yeah. Satellite. Mango. Yeah. Wow, interesting. Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. Nice. I just know it. Agreed. Okay. Very nice. Okay. Where is the link? Actually, this is already finished. Okay. Thank you, Erfigo. Yeah. Okay. And okay. Actually, this is the internet. So we want to classify. This is internet. Yes, is it correct? Yeah. Vessel tracking. What kind of information for vessel tracking? Maybe location. Location informations, services, or what kind of information from the vessel tracking system? Who is written these services? Vessel tracking system. Who is written this service? Hello, everybody.
It is actually more like in maritime systems. So
maritime.
About, yes, mm-hmm. The ships, the condition of the ship, where is it in the sea, and like the fuel system, fuel level, and you can actually check it in your phone. So the company provides some kind of application. The application name is Spatial Information System, and that is basically the explanation of Spatial Tracking System.
Okay, I understand. It's kind of a facial information system, is it correct?
Yes. And for the application, they use specialized satellite, specialized antenna called gyro antenna. So the antenna can be stabilized. As you can see, the ship is actually not stable.
Yes.
According to the sea condition. And
yes.
The antenna can be moved accordingly towards the ship, so it's applied with the gyro antenna.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, actually, it's about the vessel. Yeah, vessel information. Yeah. Special information including maybe speed, including locations, including maybe fuel and ethics, etc. Okay, thank you Erfiko, very insightful. Okay. This mobile service provided by Indosat, Excel, and maybe Telkomsel, yes? Telkomsel, yeah, maybe Three, yeah? Mm-mm. Mobile service, what kind of service here? Is basically is voice, yeah? At the beginning of the service, yeah? Voice, and then SMS, yes? SMS, and then MMS, multimedia services, and then internet, yes. This is satellite, maybe internet, yes, internet. Wi-Fi retrailer, oh yes, this is internet. But actually not only internet, because this is written internet, yeah, so this is internet, okay. And then email, okay, email is good. And Telkomsat is Coconet, yeah, Coconet, maybe, let's check together, Coconet, Telkomsat. It's kind for vessel passenger, yeah, for
yes.
Vessel passenger internet, yes, internet broadband for vessel, yeah. Wow, internet for vessel passenger, satellite phone, maybe voice, yeah, voice. This is voice, yeah, VoIP lah, VoIP, voice over internet protocol. And then facsimile. And TV broadcaster, so this is broadcasting media, maybe video plus audio, yes. And then what we can write here is you can see as a TV broadcaster, yeah, like Net TV and Indosiar TV One. This is instant messenger like WhatsApp, iMessage, Line, yes, and etc. And this is SSH, VPN, VPS, okay. Yeah, okay. And cloud services, yeah, storage services, Firebase, AWS, Amazon, Amazon Web Service, and then another lah ya, like a Google ya, yeah? Google Web Service ya, yeah? Teleconference, Zoom, okay. Yeah, actually teleconference is an applications, yeah, applications, yeah, this kind of applications. Okay, very good. Thank you very much for your participation. Yeah, it is correct. Yes, and you know that from this data, you can see here. The internet provided by Telkomsat and vessel tracking Telkomsat and mobile services, voice, SMS, MMS, internet is in Indosat, XL, Telkomsel. The satellite only Telkomsat, yeah. Mangoski and then Wi-Fi only. Can be provided by First Media, IndiHome, and etc. And so on and so on. Okay. You can see here that some of provider only serve one type of service. You can see here, for example, the Telkomsat. Telkomsat, this is from this data, yeah, from this data. Telkomsat only provide one type of service. This is internet. Okay. And for example, Metrovac only service one type of, yeah, only provide one type of service, facsimil. And actually, the TV broadcaster only provide the video and audio. Yes. This kind of business, this kind of business means that we want to simplify this case. It means that a provider only serve one type of service. Yeah. This is what happened in the last time, last decade. Yeah. Or even maybe currently still exists some of the provider, some of the provider here. Only, again, I want to point out, only serve one type of telecommunication service. And then what happened? Yeah, maybe we're talking about the last decade, like Telkom, yeah, you know, Telkom provided telephone rumah, yeah, telephone rumah, yeah, telephone rumah, you know, yeah, telephone rumah provided by Telkom maybe 10 years ago. Yeah, that's only the services. That's only the service provided by Telkom. There is no additional service. Okay. And then, like a Telkomsel at that time, they only provide voice, yeah, telephone voice and SMS, not provide internet yet. Or maybe some, yeah, but very little portion. And like First Media at that time only serve internet services, yeah. There is no provide Telkom. Maybe you remember the Bakri telephone. Maybe some of you knows at the time you heard some network provider, telecommunication provider, Bakri Telephone, but actually right now already liquidated. Only provide very cheap telecommunications. Yeah, very cheap telecommunication. You can almost call your friend with the same provider with the within Bakri Telkom, and you don't be charged. Yeah, you are not be charged, so it's free at that time. Yeah, and then what is the problem? The business model like that, it means that every provider only serve one type of communication service. Actually, this is really, really costly. Yeah, really costly. The cost is very high, and it requires the dedicated device, dedicated network. Yeah, for example, allow me to write something. Oh, it doesn't work. I plug in a wrong connector. Okay, it should be work now. Okay, yeah. Last decade, one provider serve one specific service. For example, like Telkom, yeah. Telkom only serve telepon rumah. Telepon rumah. And First Media only serve internet. Internet provider, or you can maybe some of you aware about ISP, internet ISP or ISP. Internet service provider. And maybe Telkomsel, yeah, Telkomsel only cellular. This is voice and SMS. Yeah, you can see here. So, and what is the consequence of this service? Yeah, the consequence of this service. For example, telepon rumah, it needs specific specific device, yeah, specific device. Yeah, for example, you know lah, telepon rumah, it need maybe copper wire for network, yeah, for the network. And also the terminal, yeah, terminal device. First Media maybe it's require modem internet, yeah. And for the Telkomsel, for voice and SMS, maybe require cellular phone. HP lah ya, cellular phone. Iya. You can see here every type of service require specific device. Actually, this device cannot use to internetan, yeah, for internetan, yeah. The modem is cannot use for make a call. Actually, this is only dedicated for internet. And the cellular phone at the time only dedicated for voice and SMS. Yes, very limited capability to access the internet. Very limited capability. And if we want to connect to the telepon rumah, also it's route using a complex network. Yeah. So you can see here from the perspective of perspective of cost, yeah, you can see this is require a specific cost, and this is also require specific cost, and also this is the another cost. It's mean that if one person subscribe telepon rumah, internet, and cellular, they have to pay to 3 different provider. Yeah. They have to pay to the 3 different provider, to Telkom, First Media, and Telkomsel. This is actually not effective, costly. Yeah. So based on this problem, how to optimize, how to solve this problem? Actually, how to, from the perspective of user like us, yeah, how to pay only one provider and get 3 type of service, something like that. It is more convenient, right? You pay only maybe to Telkomsel, and then you get the telepon rumah, internet, and the cellular, for example. It is more convenient from the perspective of user. Also, from the perspective of provider, it is more, how to say, efficient in term of management. In term of management, because from this point, for example, this provider owned by one holding company, it means that this holding company should pay different manager, different director, yeah, different project maybe, yeah. It's mean that really costly, yeah, really costly. Okay, so the solution is there any possibility to merge, to combine this service together? Is it possible to combine the 3 service become one provider? So that's the meaning of network convergence. Yeah, I hope you got the point. Network convergence means that we merge the different network coming from different services into one, yeah, into single network. Okay, I hope you got this point. That's what happened today, yeah, the NGN. And next generation network or network convergence still evolutes, still, how to say, developing, yeah, still take evolution, yeah. But the final purpose is to combine all the service into one network, into one physical network, So what happened today? What happened today is you already enjoy maybe the triple play. This is the brand from some of the provider telkom, yeah, telkom triple play. It means that you can connect using you can be served by telepon rumah, internet, yeah, internet service, and what, broadcasting, yeah, like a TV cable, yeah, like a TV cable broadcasting. You can watch many channel from the television provider, yeah. You can use triple play, something like that. That's kind of network convergence. Okay, until this point, is there any question?
No, sir, no questions.
No question. Okay. Okay, if no question, I will move forward to the material. Actually, this is just the beginning. It's introduction, yeah. How to say, it's a motivation, yeah, talking about this technology. Okay. Okay, actually the PowerPoint I already provided at Emas. So now you can see here, this is the overview of NGN. Yeah, overview of NGN. Look, what is the relation between NGN and network convergence? Yeah, okay. Maybe some of you asking about that, yeah. Actually, the network convergence, yeah, network convergence, this is the general meaning. And different institutions sometimes has a different specific name, yeah. For example, what we want to discuss today, what we call as NGN. This is stand for next generation network. This term provided by ITU, International Telecommunication Union. Actually, this is the union or telecommunication board in the world level. Yes. But there are also similar, yeah, the term is a different, different name, like mobile edge computing. And then there is a network function virtualization. And so on. But the principle of this technology actually this is just another meaning of the general name, the network convergence. Okay, I hope you got this point. Okay. Let's talk about the next generation network. This is the content. Okay. Definition of NGN. The definition is packet-based network able to provide telecommunication services and able to make use of multiple broadband, QoS-enabled transport technologies and in which service-related functions are independent from underlying transport-related technology. So, the NGN is packet packet-based, it means that it's similar to the internet network. Is there another type of non-packet based? Yeah, there is a circuit based. Maybe some of you is not familiar with this circuit based. The circuit based is really kind of analog, but actually not analog. Maybe I will. It's kind of a telephone rumah. The meaning is PSTN, public service telecommunication network, atau telepon rumah. Telepon rumah is kind of technology that using circuit based, not packet. Circuit based means that the information is connected through the, connection circuit. Yeah. So, for example, this is my home. My home has a number 01. Maybe Goldie home is 002. I want to call Goldie. And then the mechanism for calling, first I send to the PSTN signal, hey, I want to call Goldie, which the number is 002. This is PSTN. And the PSTN will search from the list. For example, this is a switching center. So mechanically, this kind of like a connector, like a saklar, yeah, saklar. So it's connected to this line, or this line. This connected to which line that I should route to Goldie's home. This is circuit based. So it's really, really, how to say? Yeah, really a connection network. Yeah, if we connect like a saklar, yeah, like a connector. If we connect and then we can make a communications. But if there is no connections, there is no communications. Different with the packet base, yes. The packet base is works a totally different mechanism. Yeah. For example, like connection using VoIP, yeah, it's similar voice, but if voice over internet, it means that this voice convert to the binary data, and this binary is then form into packet, yeah, into packet. The packet data, yeah, packet data. This packet, for example, using block like this, and this data is sent to the Goldie's home. Goldie's home, and then this data is rearranged. Maybe this is 1, 2, 3, 4 range, and then this data is demodulated, yeah, or decode into voice. And you can see here, this packet can arrive to the Goldie's home with different time. Maybe the first packet is through the America, USA. Maybe the router is through there, and this second packet through Japan, and this packet through the Australia maybe, and then arrive at the Goldie's home, and then rearrange, and after rearrange based on this order, 1, 2, and 3, and then decode to the voice, and my voice come up from the speaker. Okay, that's kind of differences between circuit based and packet based. And back to our topic, the next generation network is packet based network. So packet based or all internet IP, all IP packet. So in this case, multiple broadband and QoS enable. QoS, what is the QoS? QoS is quality of service, means that parameter that should be fulfilled to provide service above the standard. Yeah, this is a quality of service. This is actually the standard, yeah, standard that should be fulfilled for services. For example, when we streaming video, for example, or video broadcasting, sometimes we experience that between the image or video and audio are not synchronized. Sometimes the audio is come earlier, means that we hear the voice from the speaker a bit earlier, and the video is just coming later, and then the voice is not synchronized between the lips of the speaker, something like that. That's kind of QoS. Why we need to standardize standardize the QoS. And then the next point is a service and transport. Actually, the service, this is the type of service like a voice or SMS or internet. And the transport is the network technology. Yeah. Okay. And it enables unfettered access for user to network and to competing service provider and or service of their choice. It supports generalized mobility, which will allow consistent and ubiquitous provision of service to user. NGN is a broadband managed IP-based network. Means that the NGN actually is IP-based network. The IP-based network can be delivered, through fixed network or mobile network, or over wireless network. Means that this, you can see right now that you can access internet from fiber optic. This is the fixed network. UTP cable, this is or LAN cable, this is a fixed network. Or even by cellular network, like from your phone, even you get mobile, you can still access the internet wirelessly, something like that. That's the meaning of NGN. NGN should support those services. And in terms of feature, NGN should support different QoS, security and mobility. You can see here, there is at the last decade, the internet provider is limited by bandwidth. For example, if you access the internet from cellular, it's really limited by bandwidth. And then using NGN, the network is merged together, combined into one physical network. And then in this one physical network, divided virtually. So for example here, this is a FO, fiber optic. Maybe you subscribe to First Media. And using this fiber optic, you can access internet. Internet like a web browsing. And also, you can telepon rumah. And you can watch TV broadcaster. This different service has different requirement, QoS requirement. For example, in terms of delay. in terms of delay. What do you think? When you browsing, it is important. I mean, it is important to have. No. My question is based on the priority. Priority means that the minimum delay to the maximum delay. Which service that require minimum delay from this three different service?
Telepon rumah.
Telepon rumah. This is the most the minimum, right?
Yes.
Minimum delay. The second?
Yes. TV broadcast.
TV broadcast. Yes. So. TV broadcast or internet?
Nggak tahu, apa saya ragu.
Yeah, we put here specific application web browsing, for example. Yeah. If you compare web browsing and TV broadcast, which delay that require minimum?
Browsing.
So something like this, and this is the last.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. But everybody agree, right? The telephone rumah is should have the most minimum delay. The minimum yes. delay. Okay. Okay. Comparing to the web browsing and TV broadcast. Okay. And then. For another parameter, two-way communication. Two-way communication means that something like what to say, like a video conference. This is a two-way communications. Bidirectional communications. If we characterize from type of two-way communications, this is the priority, and this is the internet. Maybe it's comparable between the web browsing and TV broadcaster. Yeah, maybe we can write thing like this. Okay, means that two-way communication means that between when we make a phone, when we call somebody, means that we require minimum delay for two ways. I need my voice arrive at the destination on time, and I need lawan bicara kita also the voice of him should arrive on time to our device. This is two-way communications. Compared to the broadcasting is really one-way communication. One-way means that the information is delivered from the TV broadcaster to our home. There is very limited information sending from our home compared to reception. It is also similar to the web browsing. Web browsing, usually the amount of the data that we send is much lower compared to the data that we receive when we conduct the web browsing. So if we compare in terms of this is two ways communications, and then bandwidth, yeah, is bandwidth. This is the another parameter of QoS, bandwidth. The bandwidth is divided by two types, upload and download. I think you already understand differences between upload and download. So the internet browser bandwidth for upload is less than download. Agree, yeah? And telepon rumah, it should be similar. For TV broadcaster, download is much larger than upload. Yeah, that's kind of. And the problem is how to setting. Yeah, how to set QoS for different service. Yeah. Basically, this is technically this service delivered by one FO, one fiber optic, right? When you subscribe a first media, there is only one cable fiber optic connected to our modem. Yeah. And then how to distinguish different QoS using only one cable? That's we need a QoS management. QoS management. QoS management, something like that. QoS management, yeah. It means that at the server here, server, yeah, at the server should be intelligent. Should be intelligent, should be super fast, and should be powerful. Why? Because the task of the server is complicated. We should check every packet pass to the network. We need to check that this packet is classified as a web browser or voice or TV broadcaster. If the packet is voice, it should be number one priority. Number one priority. And web browser might be less priority, and TV broadcaster is more less priority. That's kind of server. This should be powerful. Something like that. Yeah, that's why there is a should be managed IP in term of quality, security, and mobility. Yeah, security. When the server checking the packet, it should be careful. It means that this packet should be route into right destinations. Yeah. Should be route into right destination, yeah. And also the mobility it should comply with the delay requirement. Usually the mobility network is really deal with the delay. Yeah, because the mobility, the network, it should be intelligent to, how to say, to determine where the location of the destinations. The evolution of from the previous generations, there is a limited bandwidth. But for the NGN to support multiple services, they should provide broadband service. That's why, yeah, broadband. The meaning of broadband mean broadband or wideband. Yeah, broadband or wideband. 5 years ago, the definition of broadband, if the download rate greater than or equal to Mbps, that's definition of broadband. If your download rate is greater than or equal to Mbps, your network is classified as a broadband network. But if your network is less than 2 Mbps, you are not in broadband network yet. This is a consequence because using a broadband, we need to serve multiple services with different KOS, something like that. Okay, that's all from this slide. Okay, the key principle of NGN is open. First is open architecture. Open to support service creations, service updating, and incorporation of service logic provision by third parties, and also support distributed control as well as enhanced security and protections. Of course, yes. What does it mean of open architecture? So in NGN, we can classify this is a user, and this is a network provider. And this is a service provider. User is like us. User is like us. For example, we want to use order food from GoFood. GoFood. This is the user of GoFood. User of GoFood order using service application or service provider. This is from Gojek, right? Gojek. And this Gojek is delivered using network provider. For example, like me, is Telkomsel subscriber, Telkomsel. Nah, this is the network provider here. Basically, the information is coming from, that moment, I use a different color. The information is like this. When we order a food, I use using maybe this one, the orange color. When we order the food, is the information is orange color from our smartphone through the Telkomsel network and to the service provider. And then the Gojek respond using a blue color here. Also, the Gojek is using network provider through network provider and finally to the user, something like that. This is open architecture, means that the service is not usually embedded to the network provider. Comparing to the maybe one decade ago, last time, yeah, when make a voice call, actually this application voice is embedded to the network provider. This manage, actually we pay to the network provider. We pay the charge, pulsa, to the network provider, to the Telkomsel. But right now, the network provider is just like a pipe, like kayak pipa. Sebagai lewat aja. Actually, we pay to the Gojek, yeah? We pay the Gojek, something like that. That's kind of a new paradigma, para new scenario, yeah, in next generation network. Independent provisioning. Yeah, that's what we already discussed. The service provisioning separated from network operation. Yeah, this is a Gojek and this is a Telkomsel. Actually, right now, Gojek is and Telkomsel is different entity, different company, something like that. And also the third aspect is multiplicity. Multiplicity is like flexibility to expand. For example, like First Media lah ya, First Media or IndiHome. Actually, from the server, this is a FO, fiber optic with large bandwidth. And then at the station close to the subscriber and then divide it. And then this is actually the connection is just multiplexing. Multiplexing means that coming from one network and then separate it into N network. Yeah. And then if there is another subscriber, just add one cable and then just plug and play, something like that. And the management of new user is not in the MUX stations, multiplexion station, but the management of new user at the server. So it's really, 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 really flexible. Compared to the, I want to make a comparison between the old technology like a telephone rumah, yeah. The telephone rumah, if we want to connect to the telephone rumah, we should in bahasa menggelar kabel yang sangat panjang very long cable connected to the switching center. Usually this cable is very long and this is not practical. This is old technology. Compared to right now, yeah, even you can create the telephone by connecting to the internet provider. Yeah, this is very simple. Maybe from the computer that access to the internet, you can create a phone connection like a Skype, like a Skype lah, as long as I know. We can call the telephone rumah through the Skype, yeah. That's kind of multiplicity. Okay, move forward. This is a feature of NGN. What we have discussed, packet-based transfer, separation of control function among base station control, call station, application, or service, decoupling of service provisioning from transport means that separated, yeah. Support for wide range of service based on service building block, yeah. Broadband capability with end-to-end QoS, interworking with legacy network via open interface, generalized mobility, unfettered access by user to different service provider, a variety of identification scheme, unified service characteristic for the same service as perceived by the user, converge service between fixed and mobile, yeah, combine, yeah, between fixed and mobile. So right now we really, how to say, maybe it is difficult to distinguish between internet provider and telecommunication provider. The telecommunication provider like a Telkomsel, Excel, right now also provide internet services, as well as the IndiHome. IndiHome, maybe in the previous generation, IndiHome only provide internet connection. Right now, IndiHome also provide telephone combined with telephone rumah and broadcasting. And then the next point is independence of service related function from underlying transport technology. Yeah, like a Gojek. Is Gojek is really independent to the network. Means that the Gojek service can be accessed through Telkomsel network, through Telkom network, through First Media network, and many as long as this is the internet, or even satellite, yeah, from satellite, if the satellite provide internet service. Support of multiple last mile technology, yes, compliant with the all regulatory requirements, yes. Next generation services, yeah, this is the next network view from comparing between the old service to the next service. This is legacy network. The old network, old technology. Service are typically vertically integrated. Yeah, vertically integrated means that it's dedicated, yeah. Telepon rumah, they use on network, ya. Jadi jaringan telepon itu ya pakai jaringannya si Telkom. Tidak bisa pakai jaringannya Telkomsel, nggak bisa. At that time. Service requires specific infrastructure component for their delivery. Iya. For example, a TV broadcasting at that time, they use a specific channel. They use only cable that dedicated only for TV broadcasting. But right now, the TV broadcasting can be accessed from internet service. Nah, this is the evolution to the NGN, flexible service creation and provisioning. Contrary to the vertical integration, this is the horizontal integration or horizontal convergence. Services are no more vertically integrated. Network functions are componentized. New paradigm of standard capabilities as service enabling toolkit. A new challenge for regulation. NGN move the competition from lower layer, yeah, to the service. The self-service development. So the objective of NGN is not only for voice service, but multiple or many type of service. Service specify in term of required capabilities. Service precise service definition are not an objective like in legacy world. Yeah. And then service expected to be supported in NGN multimedia service like a broadcasting, yeah, like yeah, data communication service, yeah, this is like a internet access, PSTN, ISDN, like a telephone rumah ini, telephone rumah. And then public interest service, this is like a specific application, specific service, like a AirVigo set that maybe layanan telecommunication in vessel, yeah, internet service in vessel, public interest service, yeah, ini like a service that very specific for the specific market, something like that. This is a specific for multimedia service and expansion of the service feature. The multimedia is very broad, yeah, very, the spectrum is very large. For example, real-time conversation voice, point-to-point interactive multimedia like real-time voice, text, video, chatting, something like that. Collaborative interactive communication like what we are doing right now using Zoom. Push-to-talk over NGN. Content delivery like radio, video streaming, yeah, content delivery. TV broadcasting, something like that. Broadcasting service, emergency communication, notifications, messaging, SMS, MMS, location-based service, yeah, like a facial tracking, yeah, something like that. Tour guide service, presence and general notification services, host-based service, hosted, and 3GPP host-based service. Something like this is the kind of multimedia services. Sorry, I need to drink for a while. Thank you. This is kind of service for telepon rumah. This is how to combine emulate and simulations between the telepon rumah existing technology to the NGN. And then this is a like regulatory and legal requirement. For example, emergency telecommunications, individual to authority, authority to authority, authority to individual, support for user with disability, lawful interception, service unbundling, number portability, network or service provider selections, prevention of unsolicited bulk telecommunications, malicious communication identification, and user identifier presentation and privacy. The concept of capabilities in the NGN please look at to this figure. Yeah, actually, it is more convenient explaining through the figure. For example, this is the applications. This is the external service and this is the internal service. In this case, we can separate, we can distinguish between the external service and the internal service. And then this external and internal can be executed by reusable blocks, means that the service creation or executions. This block is responsible for each service, either for external or internal. Means that this block can be execute for external or internal, is independent, means that reusable, yeah. And NGN capability, yeah, we should support transport connectivity, communication modes, media resource management, codec is, it is related to the, yeah, video format, audio format, something like codecs, access network and network attachment, user networks, interconnections and interoperability and networking, interworking, routing, QoS, accounting and so on, including telepon rumah ya, PSTN or ISDN. Something like that. Okay. And this is the NGN basic reference model. From the figure, the important thing that we can see here that the service layer and the transport layer, transport or equal to the network layer, it's different or separated. In this service layer also consists of user plane, control plane, and management plane, similar to the transport layer. Yeah, user plane means that this is the consists of the data user. Control plane, this is how the network works. Control plane, how to control the data for the user. The management plan is the provider how to manage each user, something like that. Also similar to the transport or network layer. Yeah, for example, yeah, Gojek, yeah. This is Gojek, this is a Telkomsel. Service layer, for example, this is Gojek and this is Telkomsel. The Gojek, what kind of user plane? Actually, when we access or order GoFood, the information, something like that, related to our order. Control plane. Control plane means that this is the software mechanism. The Gojek application should conduct when we order food. For example, the control plane, the Gojek will search possible restaurant, and then search possible driver. That's the control plan 2. And what is the management plan? Management plan is for example, how to control the billing, how to control charge, how to charge the user for management, and the management how to pay to the restaurant and how to pay the driver. That's kind of management plan. Also similar with the Telkomsel, the user plan, this is about the data, right? The data, the packet data. When we order Gojek, it's translate into the binary, yeah, binary or packet, yeah, packet data. This packet data, it should be, for example, delivered to the Abang Gojek, yeah, Abang Gojek phone. Yeah, this data should be delivered. This Telkomsel should be responsible for this delivering the data to the Abang Gojek. Yeah, yeah, something. This conducted by control plan. Okay, and the management plan. What we conduct in the management plan. So when we use the data, we charge the data. For example, means that the volume of data reduced. Our quota is reduced. This is the management plan, something like that. I hope it is clear. Okay. Okay, and this is the functional architecture. Maybe it's really complicated, but actually, this is how the NGN works. Maybe we can start from the applications. From the application here, the application actually what the user can do or user want to do. For example, I want to watch television. I want to make a call. I want to text WhatsApp, something like that. These applications. And this application actually contact to the service stratum or service layer. This is the application support function. A service support function, and this is this service delivery platform making use of NGN easily. Yeah, and this is this application store using a profile function here, and this is the NGN component connected to the another network like a PSTN or ESDN. This is or connect to the IP network, IP multimedia service component. And this application actually access to the what the transport network. This is the green almost yeah green Tosca yeah green Tosca. This is representing a transport or network. In the network consists of user profile and resource and admission control functions. What we already talk about the like maybe controlling the our quota yeah quota when we access the internet from Telkomsel, Excel or any providers, and also how the networks this connected to the legacy application or the old technology like maybe another provider, yeah, that still use the old technology like a satellite. Maybe the satellite is still spirited right now. Satellite, this is the gateway to exchanging the information, something like that, or different network, Yeah, it is possible too. Okay. Yeah, this is another how to say another view. Actually, it's similar with this, but it's more maybe look at from the provider's perspective. But in this diagram, it's really from the service perspective. And this is the impact of NGN architecture. You can see here, this is service, can be voice, telephony, data, or information, or broadcasting. This is the switching mechanism from circuit, packet, and packet to the transmission and medium transmission. And this is still narrow band. The bandwidth is still small, and then combined to the in the NGN era, voice, internet, video, and multimedia messaging into IP-based network, convert into IP-based network, transfer using fixed or mobile optic with optical fiber optic And you can see the old network is really complicated. You can see it's very complex, very much connections, cable combined, different technology combined, something like this. In NGN, you can see it's more simple. Consists of, this is the powerful server, and this is the distributed server, and this is the server close to the user, something. And the connection is all of fiber optic to support broadband connection. And then the objective of QoS, when we talk about QoS, we should provide different QoS. NGN provide initial set of requirement, architecture, and mechanism, and guideline to enable end-to-end EOS. Focus on resource and admission control, including coordination between access and core, as well as between core and other NGN network. Security objective, should follow IETUT recommendation with number X805, addressing and following security dimension like access control and authentication. And another parameter like non-repudiation, data confidentiality, communication security, data integrity, availability, and privacy. Addressing the incoming security feature required from secure connection with other NGN or existing network. This is the security that should be considered. This is mobility management, because the NGN should support mobility management. The mobile user requirement, no major new interface for mobility, and nomadism, nomads, mobility without maintaining service continuity. Yes, actually, in simple words, the NGN should support current mobile network. Should be connected, should be able to connect the existing mobile provider like Telkomsel, XL, Tri, Indosat, And then finally, enabling for convergence means that the network combine into one physical network. Yes, something like this. In one physical network here, consists of different applications, something like FMCC, RFID, IPTV, and others. So, the legacy network, this is the old technology. It service with different network. But right now, many service with one network. Different access with one network. Yeah, that this also another perspective. The top layer is applications, and this is the parameter that should be managed, like QoS, security, media handling, and etc. And this is the network that should be supported by the NGN. Fixed broadband, wireless broadband, mobile broadband, and another type of broadband, satellite and so on. This is the structure of legacy network, and this is the current network. Yeah, you can see here the core network is converged, and the access network is still can be variation, yeah, because some of you already have a fiber connection, some of you still a copper connection, but you can see here the transport network already combined into one compared to the legacy network. Reduction in number of nodes or number of network. Okay, this is kind of future use of NGN. The connection is not only human to human, but can be machine to machine. Human to machine and machine to human. Already happened today. Like a Gojek is like a human to machine. Human to machines. Like, how to say, maybe Google Translation, Google Translation, Siri, or Google, Hello Google, yeah, Hello Google, or Siri in iPhone, yeah, it's like a human to machine, something like that. And that's all. This is the overview about the NGN. Is there any questions, please? In any page, you can ask me. Okay, is there any question? Is that clear? Or related to the assignment? Please, if you have a question.
Sir, I want to make sure, sir.
Yes, please.
So the assignment is we make a video about this material that you already explained to us, but the material we create on our own, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I mean, is it a must to all the material you explained today, we must explain it, or in case I already understand 80% of it, so I will explain 80%, or must 100% from your presentation must be explained?
Okay. Basically, the good assignment cover all of the material, the all material in a simple way. No need to really how to say, no need to be same as what the material I explained today, but you can maybe it's too long, yeah, right? It's too long if you explain all the material, but you can explain by your understanding what is the NGN in your mind. It is better, yeah. I suggest you to use a one page slide. Yeah.
Okay. Now I can understand. So like it's like summary, right?
Yes, like a summary. Yes.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Yeah. So if no question, let's move forward to the assignment. So I make it on. So in the first assignment, please submit the YouTube link that you have uploaded, yeah, from the video you have uploaded, and then just copy and paste, and that's all. What the video is just summary of what material today. Explain. No need to. Actually, the PowerPoint is consists of 27, yeah, if I not mistake. Yeah, 26 page. No need to explain the 26 page, but please explain what you understood about the NGN, something like that. Maybe you can start from the motivation of the NGN. What is the motivation, the NGN, and then what is the problem that we want to solve, and then the solution is the NGN, and the NGN is kind of what blah 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 blah. The benefit of NGN is kind of something like that. And the application of the NGN is something like that. Comparing to the legacy network or legacy technology, what is the benefit of NGN? Something like that. I hope it is clear. And please conduct the assignment seriously, because it will be uploaded, and everybody can access. If you contribute the material clearly, and it will be accessed many people, will be accessed by many people and takes the benefit to the others, something like that. Okay, I think that's enough. And that's all. Thank you very much for your attentions. Stay healthy. Yes?
Sorry, sir. So because this meeting is being recorded, yes. Is it possible for you to maybe upload the recording so we can access it?
Yes, of course. But maybe after 2 or 3 days later.
Okay, no problem, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Okay. Any other question before closing?
Sir, for the video assignment, do we need to have our